What if a simple zip file could open a Trojan door into Russia's automobile giants? Deep in October 2025, a brand new .NET backdoor, hiding behind tax forms, began creeping into systems. They called it CAPI Backdoor, and once inside, it could steal browsers, snapshots, secrets. In 5 minutes, I'm going to show you how this stealthy attack works, why it's a big deal, and what twist no one saw coming. Stay with me. Before we dive in, if you love cinematic cyber breakdowns like this, hit subscribe. Why this matters? In Russia, the auto industry and online commerce are strategic economic pillars. A breach here isn't just theft, it's espionage, disruption, possibly geopolitical leverage. And this isn't some old malware we saw last year. This is fresh, unknown, cunning. Our story begins with a decoy, an email that looked innocent. But inside, a ticking bomb. On October 3, 2025, a suspicious zip file showed up on VirusTotal, named Pereraset Zarabotnoj Platy, the 1st of October 2025, payroll recalculation. Inside, a decoy PDF and a Windows shortcut, LNK, file. The PDF touted tax changes, totally normal. But that .LNK, it was the trigger. It called Rundle32.exe to load a malicious .NET implant, named Adobe.dll. This is classic living off the land, using trusted Windows binaries to fly under the radar. Here's how it operates. The LNK script executes Rundle32.exe with parameters to invoke the .NET backdoor. Once loaded, the .NET implant, CAPI backdoor, checks if it's running as admin, enumerates installed antivirus software, and quietly opens the decoy PDF to distract the user. Next, it reaches out to C2.91.223.75.96 and awaits commands: steal browser data, Chrome, Edge, Firefox, take screenshots, list folders, exfiltrate files, system info, all while asking, is this a VM or real host? It also sets up persistence via scheduled tasks and startup folder LNKs, copying itself into roaming directories. In short, stealth, persistence, data pilfering, the full toolkit. Why target automotive, e-commerce? Because in Russia, those industries hold valuable financial and operational data. The attackers used a spoofed domain carpulce.ru, looks like carprice.ru, to lure victims. They also registered multiple DGA domains and redirected traffic cleverly, hiding the real C2 inside layering. Infrastructure resided in Russian ASN segments, e.g. as Reg, PA, K, TLLC, and they masked traffic over port 443. So what looks like ordinary HTTPS traffic may in fact carry stolen secrets. Their foothold could spread, lateral movement, espionage, full system takeover. This is not just local theft, it's strategic infiltration. So far, we know the backdoor is new, clean, no prior signatures. This gives it stealth advantage. But here's the twist, because this campaign is so fresh, it's likely still evolving. Could modules beyond data theft be added? Remote execution, lateral movement, eventual sabotage. Also, while Russia is the focus, the method is generic. Any country with auto, e-commerce players could be next. And the most chilling, the attackers may already be inside, lying dormant, watching, waiting for the next stage. The real damage may not yet be visible. Here's your takeaway. A backdoor like CAPI proves one simple truth: the weakest link is often trust. A tax notice. A zip. An everyday binary. In 2025, cyber war is won by silence, concealment, and patience. If you want to stay one step ahead of the next surprise malware, hit subscribe, ring that bell, and check out our playlist on advanced threat breakdowns. This story is just opening. See you in the next one.